The next topic is what makes India a federal country? We have earlier seen how small countries like Belgium and Sri Lanka face so many problems of managing diversity. What about a vast country like India with so many languages, religions and regions? What are the power sharing arrangements in our country? Let us begin with the constitution. India had emerged as an independent nation after a painful and bloody participation. So, as we have already learned in history, that is in the chapter Nationalism in India, how the Indian leaders had struggled against the British ruler and how we got independence by working very hard, and the struggle was very painful. So, and the constitution which we have made, it was also made up of so much effort, and still we continue the same rules and regulation which our leaders had made our Indian constitution. Soon after independence, several princely states became a part of the country. The constitution declared India as a union of state. Although it did not use the word federation, the Indian government is based on the principles of federalism. Though in our constitution the word federalism was not added, but still we follow the basic principles of federalism. Let us go back to the seven features of federalism mentioned above. We can see that all these features apply to the provision of the Indian constitution. The constitution originally provided for a two-tier system of government. The union government, or what we call the central government, representing the union of India, and the state government. Later, a third tier of federalism was added in the form of panchayat and municipalities. So, when we got independence from the British rule, we have only two tier system, that is the central and the state government. But as the requirement of third tier was needed, then the Indian leaders, or you can say the Indian administrator, they had finally said that we need a third tier, that is panchayat and municipality at the local level. As in any federation, these different tiers enjoy separate jurisdiction, though there are certain powers which are allotted to these three tiers. They enjoy their separate powers. The constitution clearly provides a threefold distribution of legislative powers between the union government and the state government. Thus, it contains three lists. So, as the our powers are divided into three parts, that is central, state and local government, that is municipalities and panchayat, on the basis of these category, the Indian government had also divided the list into three parts, that is the first is union list, the second is state list, and the third is concurrent list. Now we will study in detail what actually these lists are in the next video.